Today I'm going to be doing back of traps. To do something a little bit different, I'm going to hit traps first because I normally hit them last. And I'm going to do two exercises instead of just the one. So that way I'm getting a little bit more volume and I'm going to hit them when they're fresh so that I can try and bring up that area. Not that it's lagging, but I just feel like I want to try and target them a little bit more for the next, say, 4 or 5 weeks or something. And then I'll just move into my regular back workout, like my trap pull downs and all that sort of thing. So yeah, I'm gonna hit barbell shrugs and then dumbbell shrugs after.
With him and let him eat my ass like a cupcake. My man fool, he just ate. I don't duck nobody but tape. Yeah, that was a setup for a punchline on duct tape. Worry about if my butt fake. Worry about y'all niggas.
Right, so I just did 4 sets on that with the drop set on the last one. So I dropped it back to 100 kilos and then down to 60. Now I'm going to move on to my second exercise, which will be the dumbbell shrug.
Big titties, big butt too. Fuck with them real niggas who don't tell niggas what they up to. Had to show bitches where the top is. Ring finger where the rock is. These hoes couldn't test me, even if the name was Pop Quiz. Mad bitches who I fuck with, mad bitches we don't fuck with. I don't fuck with them chickens unless they last name is Cutlet. Let it soak in like seasoning. And tell them bitches blow me Lance Stevenson.
Freeze every bottle and cup in the sky. Sparks in the air like the 4th of July. Nothing but bad bitches in here tonight. Oh, if you lame and you know it, be quiet. Nothing but real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only. Independent bitches only. Real niggas only. Bad bitches only. Rich niggas only, independent bitches only. Real niggas only, real niggas only. Real niggas only, bad bitches only. Only, 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 only.
I like my girls BBW.
Exercises now, so I'm going to be hitting the barbell rows superset with the cable pull downs like I did last week. So I'm going to do three sets on this, and then I'm going to do 2 sets of pin lay rows, which is basically just a barbell row, but you're bending over it a little bit more, taking your legs out of it and just pulling through your elbows.
Yeah, low key and maybe high key. I've been peeped that you like me, you know. Who the fuck you really want to be? What besides me? I mean, it doesn't take much for us to do this shit quietly. I mean. She say I'm obsessed with thick women and I agree. Yeah, that's right, I like my girls. Yeah, type don't wanna suck you dry and then eat some lunch with you. Yeah, so thick that everybody else in the room is so uncomfortable. Ass on Houston, Texas, but the face look just like Claire Huxtable. Oh, yeah, you the man in the city when the mayor fuck with you. The NBA players fuck with you. The badass bitches doing makeup and hair fuck with you. Oh, that's cause I believe in something and I stand for it. And Nikki, if you ever try to fuck, just give me the heads up so I can plan for it.
Alright, so there you go, just superset those 2 exercises. I did about 10 reps on each. And really trying to focus on not using my other body parts to assist too much. So really trying to isolate my back through the rows. And then I've watched my videos back on that exercise a couple of times and noticed that I let the weight carry me up quite quickly. So I've been trying to focus on just controlling it from the eccentric phase a little bit more. And then re-engaging from my lower lats before I start pulling down, rather than just pulling through my triceps. So yeah, small improvements every week. That's the aim of the game.
Only.
basically just bending over the bar a little bit more and pulling straight through the elbows and trying to hit the rhomboids rather than the lower lats and that. So I'm going to do two sets by one average weight for 15 reps and then bump it up to a heavier weight for about 10 reps.
You get on international first class seat on my lap, girl, riding comfortable. I know what that girl them need. New York to Haiti, I got lipstick stamps on my passport. You make it hard to leave.
Alright, so with the pen lay row, you also you need a rest at the bottom of every rep rather than doing them continuously. That way you can sort of turn the muscle off, re-engage it, and then focus on where you want to pull through. So I'm trying to hit the upper back and trap area, and also then the lower lats now.
Get jazzy on it.
Alright, so you probably would have noticed that I haven't even done my one-arm rows yet, which is like one of my staple movements for bringing up my back. Reason being is I'm pretty happy with the width that I'm carrying through my back, so I'm just focusing on more my rowing movements today, so I can try and add in that thickness to my upper back and trap area. Now, I was thinking about doing some T-bar rows or some seated rows now, but my leg's pretty sore from yesterday, so ruled out doing the T-bars, and then I thought, oh, why don't I do the hammer strength, because then that way I can engage my traps a little bit more. So I'll probably do about three sets on this, and then maybe do a couple sets on the seated row.
We get drunk in the club.
Focusing on bringing my shoulders right back and squeezing through my upper back and then controlling it on the eccentric phase as well. Basically just kind of pull hard and then release quickly and just focus on pulling, where now I'm trying to get that time under tension, and I find that that works a lot better when it comes to adding in detail. Shit.
If you're fucking the night.
Down, one to go. The main important thing to focus on when you're doing this movement is to maintain that arch through your back. You don't want to round your back out like this and just pull through your arms. You want to make sure you stick your chest up, keep your lower back straight, and pull through the elbow, and then let that shoulder joint drop down and pull back up. If you find that you're just rotating like that too much, you're probably just using other muscle groups. So the best way to do it is to arch your back, stick your chest up, engage your lower lat, keep your elbow tucked in, and just focus on pulling through that lower lat. Up with some barbell curls, put some blood in the biceps, chunky like a monkey.
Cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies, and I'm not proud of my address in the torn up town. No postcode envy, but every song's like gold teeth, gray goose dripping in the bathroom, mistakes, ball gowns, trash in the hotel room. We don't care. I'm driving Cadillacs in our dreams, but everybody's like crystal, Maybach, diamonds on your timepiece, jet planes, islands, tigers on a gold leash. We don't care. We aren't caught up in your love. Be royal, royal. Isn't what it our love. That kind of love just ain't for us. We crave the different kind of love. Let me be your
So I just got home, which means it's meal time. I already had 3 meals for today, so I had 2 prep meals and my oats. I think I had peri chicken, which is chicken thigh and brown rice, and then I had steamed fish and brown rice. So now it's time for my dinner, but I'm not gonna have any more carbs because I'm not training tomorrow. So I'm just gonna have steamed fish. Whoa, we like super zoomed in. Steamed fish and like a salad. So spinach, onion, tomatoes, that sort of thing. Keep the carbs low now. And then eggs for dinner. So yeah, I'm gonna cook this up real quick, and then I'm gonna eat it and maybe take the dog to the park. All right, so I'm just getting my salad ready while the fish is steaming. Just put some spinach in there with some onion, tomatoes, and then chopped up the capsicum. Now I'm gonna make some zucchini spaghetti. So you get a zucchini and you get one of these things, which you can buy them from like the supermarket, and you twist it up in there like that, and then it comes out the other end like spaghetti, and it's really good for your salads because a little bit of crunch, and that gives it a nice texture. So I'm gonna show you. All right, and that's what it looks like when it comes out the other end. So now I'm gonna just put
1 tablespoon of flaxseed oil, some balsamic vinegar, and some salt. Mix it up, and then I have the fish as well with my sweet chili sauce. And that's my dinner. So yeah, quickly eat that. Shit yeah, you know what time it is. Crack open a cold Pepsi Mac. Right, I'm gonna put my sweet chili light sauce on there. So it's got like 7 calories per serving. And then I've got my flaxseed oil, balsamic vinegar, and salt on the salad. So that's my low-fat dressing. And that's how we get lean. Pour that shit all up on there. Don't be shy. Stir it up. Oh, damn. I'm already hungry again. So I'm cooking up my next meal. I'm going to have some more steamed fish. And then I'm going to just have some fillers. So mushrooms, tomatoes, and onion. There's basically like no calories in there. Like there's a little bit, but not much to really even bother counting. I just cook up a whole lot of mushrooms with some tomatoes and that, and then I just fill it the container up with that, and then add some spinach too. So it's a very basic meal, no carbs, and then I'm going to have some jelly light. I'm going to cook up the jelly light, and have that later on if it sets in time as my like dessert, and then my last meal will just be some eggs. So I'm back on that Shreds diet for the weekends, from now until the weekends. And then hopefully I'll just lean up a little bit from doing that. I'm going to do some cardio tomorrow as well and have low carbs tomorrow again. But yeah, let me cook this up and then I'll show you when I'm done.
All right, so there we go. Got my steamed fish, the tomatoes and mushrooms and onions. Then I'll put some spinach in there. A little bit of sweet chili light sauce again. Mix it up. And then that's my meal.